Freeman QC from Among Us. This tutorial will be about shrinking images on Linux, which is an art to find, so I'm making it. I can't find it anywhere in video, like easy showing it. So what you need is a Linux PC, or in my case a virtual machine running in my Mac. It may work from a boot live CD or boot USB key, live key, I don't know. You may just try it and let us know in the comments. You need a bit of knowledge on the terminal, how it works, but I think the video is pretty straightforward. You should figure out even if you don't know much. And of course, an image file. So first thing first, open up your terminal. Here, mistype sudo ap install gparted. Okay, so you enter your password, there we go. Alright, as you can see, it's already installed, but I wanted to show you the command. You'll be asked to press Y, press enter for yes, and then it will install. You can close the terminal. Next step is to create a folder. Name it whatever you want. I'm gonna call mine image. Take your image and drag it in the folder. I'm gonna show you, for the purpose of this tutorial, that my image file makes 32.1 gigabyte in size. So we'll right click the image folder we just created, the folder that your image sits in, and click open in terminal. So now we've got this folder with all its content open in the terminal. The next step is to create a loopback device. I'm gonna try to explain this easy for you. A loopback device is, it's like taking an image file and make it show like a device, so it will appear in gparted as a device, so you'll be able to resize it just like you would with an hard drive a device. So we'll first do sudo mode probe loop, and that will enable the loopback. So password again, here we go. So now loopback is enabled. We'll request a new loopback device. So sudo lo setup minus f. So we've got loop 0. Now we need to create a device for our image. So the command is sudo lo setup dev loop 0. And then your image name, mine is emoga.img, press enter. Good. So now we have a device for our image. We need to ask the kernel to load it so we can access the partition. So we'll do sudo part probe dev loop 0. Enter. Done. So now we need to resize the partition. Now it's all ready to be resized. We're gonna do this sudo gparted dev loop 0. Enter. And then this opens up gparted. As you can see, you have the image file with all the three partitions. So you have the boot partition, Recalbox, share. What we're gonna do today is touch the share partition here. So you see there's 6.62 gigabyte unused. You can recover all of this, I'm gonna show you, but you'll be able to recover some space on that, so it's burnable to any SD card. So let's right click to the share partition, press resize move. Once you're here, if you do that completely to the left, it won't work. So for an image of this size, by experience, I would go like maybe at 23,000. So numpad doesn't work. And you can add like 12 megabytes of free space preceding, so sometimes it won't work with some FAT32 drive. I don't know for this, I'm just gonna do it just to be sure. So it's always best to add some megabyte here, 10, 8, 12, like something like that. So resize move, blah, blah, press OK on that. And then what we'll try to do, we'll try to apply all operation. So an error occurred while applying the operation. That means we've removed too much space. So we're gonna close that. It resets. Right click on the share partition and press resize move. All right. And then take your increase by like 500 megabyte a time and see if it works. Add the free space here, resize remove. Press OK on the advertisement, on the warning, sorry. Apply all operation and hopefully it will work. So yes, it can take a bit of time. So now it is done. When it says all operations successfully completed, you're gonna press close and you're gonna just close gparted. Just before we close, I'm gonna show you, you see unallocated 4.92 gigabyte. We need to shave this from our image file, so the size will go to 22.95 gigabyte. So close gparted, we don't need it anymore. Back in the terminal. This part is not always easy to figure out. First, we don't need to loop back devices anymore. So we're gonna unload it with sudo hello setup minus d dev loop zero. Password. Here we go. So now if you try to load another image, it will work. If you don't do that comment, you'll be stuck with this image in this loop. So now shaving the image, we'll do the common F disk so we can see where the bytes end so we can shave it. So you're doing F disk, F disk minus L and the name of your image, minus M, we've got an IMG, press enter. So now we're gonna make this bigger a bit. Here we go. So we can see we've got our tree partition here. We can see too that the here you have the sector size of 512 bytes here. That is important, which should be always this number most of the time. And we can see that our big partition here, the one we're interested, the 23 gigabyte one, this number means that the partition ends on that exact byte at 512 bytes. So I'm gonna go ahead with the comment. So what you do is take this number you have that differs from mine and take this number here and we'll build a comment to truncate, to shave the part that we don't need so the file size reduces. So the comment is truncate size $523.98.079. So this is important again, this number is different for you. Here you do plus one. So why you do plus one is that the block ends there, so we don't want to hand the image there. Otherwise, the partition will not fit your image, so you need to add plus one byte. So plus one, close the parentheses. Here, and then you enter your block, your sector size. Close this. Here you go, and your image name. Mine is emulga.img. You gotta open it even bigger so you can clearly see. So trunk head minus minus size both. So yeah, you press enter. And then it's done. You can see the new size is 26.8 gigabyte. Victory, and this method works for any image, no matter what's the partition. This tutorial will work with any images. So thanks to Software Bakery website who made this tutorial. Actually, it's by FrozenCow and it works beautifully. So thank you for watching. Hope this app helped you.